I've often wondered where my artistic side comes from. Was it my dad's love of film? My mother's ability to draw? Or did it come from somewhere else? I try making art as much as possible, but I am my own harshest critic. Sometimes I find it hard to create. Often, when I find myself at a creative blockage, I reflect on this question, and recently, while exploring around my mother's basement, I found my answer, tucked away in boxes of photos from my grandpa. My first memories of my grandpa are of him sitting in his living room, listening to loud opera, painting beautiful landscapes with farmland and deer. In my lifetime, he was a prolific painter, churning out many different paintings over the course of a single year. From my perspective, taking requests for paintings and then giving them away as gifts was his main occupation. It was only years after he passed away that I learned that art had not always had such a special place in his life. He had given up art for many years to dedicate more time to his job, a decision that he later regretted. Painting had become an integral part of his early childhood, and had become a coping mechanism for my grandpa, who sometimes had a difficult time of life. My grandpa was born in 1928 in the Philippines, in Manila, to Mariano and Felisa Hinas. He was the fifth of seven children, and the first one in the family to be born in a hospital. Mariano was a minister of the United Methodist Church, and as such, much of my grandpa's early life revolved around the church and the people in it. It was through the missionary of the church that my grandpa received his first gift from outside his own family. The gift included a crayon set and a pencil and eraser. He began sketching and drawing whenever he could, filling up all his paper and needing to erase pages to have more room to draw. His father eventually noticed and bought him his first set of oil paints. As World War II raged, my grandfather used painting as a coping mechanism for the trauma he witnessed in his home. When enemy bombers strafed his village, he and his family would flee into the mountains where they would wait for the fighting to end. Hiding amongst the mountains, peering out over his village, he would fall in love with landscapes. He had amassed quite a few paintings when his house in Quezon City burned to the ground, destroying all his early work, and most of his family history as well. By that time, he had decided to study medicine. Soon after his studies in the Philippines, and with $200 in his pocket, he left for surgical training in the United States. His first few months in the United States were spent traveling to the classic destinations, New York, Chicago, Washington, D.C. My grandpa purchased his first camera for this trip, and he soon began to fall in love with photographing the uniqueness of the place he now called home. Eventually, he met my grandma.
I saw my wife, first of all, when she was a student, and I was also training in surgery, where all the students were coming down to eat in the cafeteria. I happened to look to all the students. I noticed her, and when I saw her, I thought I'd like to have a date with her. Mm-hmm.
My grandpa, overcoming a pretty serious language barrier, managed to ask her out on a date to the orchestra. They played Tchaikovsky's Sixth Symphony. A few months later, they were married. They had three children together, my mom and her two sisters. His career proved to be more time-consuming than he had ever thought it could be, and as he spent more and more time working, he spent less and less time painting. While studying in Galesburg, Illinois, a doctor named Dr. Wishak invited my grandpa over for a holiday dinner. After eating, Dr. Wishak brought my grandpa into his little basement to show him the studio he had set up there. He told my grandpa about how he had lost 10 years of his life due to mental illness, and how these paintings were his effort to make up for lost time. A few days before Christmas that year, my grandpa received one of Dr. Wishak's paintings as a Christmas gift. This gift meant a lot to my grandpa, and motivated him to start painting again. But he found trying to juggle painting and work was just too difficult, and in the middle of working on an autumn landscape, he stopped painting altogether. 18 years later, as my grandpa approached retirement, he decided to pick up from where he left off. He finished the autumn landscape, and then another. Then he began painting many different paintings each year. When his daughter was dying of breast cancer, and when his own cancer eventually overtook him, one thing that always brought him comfort was painting.
Hey, Grandpa, what do you think about your grandson?
Yes, he's learning to know me. Mm-hmm. Look at that, he's looking at me.
Yeah.
I started to talk to him, and he just looked at me. Here he is, just looking at me talk.
Growing up, whenever we would visit my grandpa, I would always spend time watching him paint in his living room, completely unaware that the whole time I was receiving my first art lesson. I can see now that my grandpa's ambition for painting was his effort at making up for lost time, the same way that Dr. Wishak had done many years before. He spent most of his middle life too focused on work, unable to provide himself a space to pursue his creativity. Being a creative person myself, and seeing how happy he was when he was able to be creative, stresses to me how important it is to have that creative outlet. For myself, it's photography, which, admittedly, I haven't been doing too much of in the last year, mainly due to self-esteem issues. I see myself eventually becoming like Dr. Wishak, letting my own mind prevent me from creating. But then, I look at the pictures my grandpa took, and I worry less. It seems good photography runs in my family. I can see many similarities in our art. We both love nature. We both love sunsets and silhouettes. And we both love photographing flowers. Before my grandpa died, he gave me his camera. It was my first camera. And because I didn't know how to use it, I didn't actually take many pictures with it at the time. I never had a chance to show him any of my photography, although I assumed he would have enjoyed it. He was, after all, the one who showed me the beauty of images.